Fish versus meat. What's healthier?
It's like a super complicated question. Like,
why?
Because, again, it's not necessarily healthier or unhealthier.
What fish and what
it's
meat?
It's how you cook it. Is it broiled? Is it fried?
It's so much even more than that. It's your whole diet. It's your activity levels. It's what calories you need at what times and what nutrients, you know? I can't just say this and not that,
okay,
that and not this.
Going green and just eating salads, is that the most healthy thing I could do?
look.
Again, super complicated questions, Ellie, that I can't. Yes, for you, Ellie, eating greens only would be a tremendous improvement for you.
Are you talking about going vegetarian?
Yeah.
I read this thing. 80%, somewhere around 70-80% of all people that go vegetarian go back to eating meat within a year.
Because they like the way it tastes?
And it's a natural, we're omnivores, it's our natural thing, we like, it's what we eat, it's what gives us the nutrition we need. Eating vegetables all the time, vegetables are great for you. You need a shit ton of vegetables and not get fat, but you get super fine skin.
And there's even more to it than just that nutritional information. Did you know this? Did you know that drinkers outlive non-drinkers?
I didn't know that.
So moderate drinkers outlive non-drinkers, abstainers. Now, heavy drinkers die quicker. But why would a moderate drinker outlive an abstainer?
They say a glass of wine before you go to bed is very healthy.
Or how about this? It has nothing to do with the health of it. It has to do with the social aspect behind going out and having a beer with your friends and having a life where you can have that type of release compared to somebody who doesn't, who maybe doesn't have those social networks that have to do with these eating rituals. Why, a glass of red wine a day is blah blah this and blah blah that. Yeah, you know what? You can study red wine and see beneficial things to it. But guess what? A person who has a glass of red wine probably has healthier lifestyle in general than a guy who drinks a case of Budweiser.
I've heard you talk to your fighters here, and you tell them have 5 meals, small portions, versus 3 giant meals. Why is that? Why do you want the meals to be spread out throughout the day?
So your calories, your nutrition is evenly coming at you throughout your day, so there's not huge peaks and valleys as far as blood sugar and nitrogen retention and things like that.
But the way you look at it, I mean, there's a big paleo diet thing coming out right now.
What's that?
Paleo basically just means old or ancient. It's basically like, you know, when you're a paleontologist, somebody who studies ancient shit. It's like the opposite of neo, which just means new. Paleo diet literally is a type of diet. The way human beings have eaten for hundreds of thousands of years before, like, the last few thousand years is literally going in tribes for 3 to 4 days up to a week, not eating, looking for something to eat, finally getting that one day where they get to eat, or 2 days.
Wait, you want me to go hunting and go and look for some squirrels in my neighborhood?
I'm not talking about literally doing it. I'm not saying go out to a fucking forest and start
working. What was the average life expectancy caveman?
No,
20, 30?
That's true. But that was usually from diseases like, you know, not caring for your teeth, or, you know, sleeping around your shit most of the time.
So, Brennan.
The disease of not caring for your teeth.
When you said to spread out the meal, so I wake up at 5 a.m., I have a little breakfast, the oatmeal cereal. 10 a.m., have a little snack. 1 o'clock, lunch. 3 o'clock, 7 o'clock, go to bed.
Look, if an average human being should eat 2,000 calories a day, yeah, from the moment you wake up to the moment you go to sleep, you should divide those calories into 5 eating sessions and have that amount of calories constitute those, you know?
Is that true, 2,000 a day?
That's the average person.
That's nothing.
A training athlete should have much more calories. I'm probably around the 3,000 mark. 145-pound active person, I'm eating around 3,000 calories. And just, yes, like I am. I space you out 5-6 meals a day. Each one is about 400 calories a pop. All right, and I hit my nutrient anabolic window directly after training. That's something that all athletes can take advantage of.
Are you that disciplined, coach, that you maintain your same weight throughout the last 15-20 years?
I weigh the same as when I graduated high school 15 years ago.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's not normal.
or it's absolutely normal.
I don't think that's the norm. I don't think that's, most people do not weigh. How old are you now? 32 So you've been out of high school 14 years.
Yeah.
And you weighed a cent. Any advice for fighters watching this about eating habits? The final words.
Yeah, I mean, as I introduced this, start educating yourself. Don't rely on me. Don't rely on that guy for sure as hell.
He said,
start
for you.
Your education, bro. This is you. This is your body. You, and especially the athlete. I mean, there is a direct correlation.
You work in a Japanese restaurant and a Thai restaurant. Why is it when I eat sushi?
Vietnamese, sorry.
Confusing. Why am I still hungry after I eat sushi? What's wrong with that?
Light. When you go to a Japanese restaurant, it's small portions.
That's why, huh? So eat less?
Eat less and move more.
There you have it. FuseReport.com. I'm Malik Sekbak reporting.